In this section of the tutorial, I'm going to show you how to connect the previously set up inspection to the CIB software. So I opened up the inspection, and what I'm going to do is copy the inspection state. So if I click the little window above it, it puts it in the center of the screen, and I can right click and say copy. That copies the inspection. I'm going to go and open the LM3 template, inspection template, which is provided with the CIB. And I'm going to delete off the inspection that's already set up in there. And I'm going to paste in the one I just set up. So I also need to reattach the transitions. Don't grab just the text, grab the actual arrow. And then we also need to create new transitions for fail versus pass. So you gotta highlight the state and say create new transition. And these are just generic transitions, so I need to associate them with a result of the inspection step. So if I say edit transition, you can name it, which is wise. But I'm gonna select the measurement distance and have it go to the fail part when that step fails. So I'll do pass for the pass side of the flow. So there's a few other adjustments that you'll need to make. First of all, I'm going to delete off the simulate acquisition from the inspection step because I already have it in the loaded images state. And I'm going to go find where those images are at, which in my case is in a folder called Yenfeng from October 9th. So this folder contains a set of different images. Left-hand airbag versus right-hand airbag. I'm going to set it to a similar image to what I was using to set up the inspection and have it cycle through the folder. And then I actually ran the inspection, which resulted in a failure. And so if I go into the inspection, I can see which steps actually failed. So I went back and I verified that the simulate acquisition is pointing to the right location. And now I'm going to go back into inspect. I have to actually say OK to get out of the simulate acquisition. So now if I go back to the match for fine connector, if you move the inspection state or copy and paste, it requires you to redo your templates. So I'm going to go and reset up the templates. You can also work within the LM3 template and just modify the inspection there as well. So that's another option. So I redid the template for the fine connector, and I'm going to redo the template for the fine clip. This will fix this issue. All the rest of the settings remain the same, I've found. It's just the templates get lost when you start moving the inspection state around from configuration to configuration. So now that is fixed. And now my measure distance step passes. So I'm going to save. I'm going to run it. You will notice that the image logging step is failing because there's no path to where to store the image with overlay. You'll also notice that this TCP step fails, and that's because we're not connected to the CIB to have a handshake. So if you want to run some tests on your own, I suggest lowering this timeout down to 500 milliseconds, that'll allow you to test images rather quickly. Because as you'll see in the flow chart, when the check part presence step fails, it goes to the load image from file step. So you can load from the local drive. So I'm going to go through and test a few of these, make sure everything's working okay, and then save. Now I'm going to go back to the CIB software and into the options and check on Do Vision Analysis. You'll notice when you set up Do Vision Analysis, it will open the Vision Inspection server. You can minimize that. Note that you do not want to have the VBAI open while you do this, so make sure it's closed. So the next step is to set up the actual analysis. I had a step previously set up in here for this, so I'm going to delete that configuration and add a new one. So I'm going to add a new model, and in this case, for the new model, if I leave the model value empty, it's going to run this inspection on every image I acquire from the camera selected, which is the airbag camera previously set up. So when I finish the configuration, I can hit the test inspection button and you'll see that a window pops up showing the results of the inspection. So there's one other thing I need to do, and I need to set the step which I'm going to look for the pass-fail result. And you'll see that that's the distance measurement, step 14. You can also count it in the VBAI, but I just do it this way. So I can run a test, I can determine which result step I want to look at, and enter it in the configuration. So now I press OK to save those results. I save the settings. I close the configuration, at which time the configuration reloads, and now I'm waiting for a start signal. So if I press the grab button, in this case, I'll get the barcode prompt as usual, enter a barcode, and it acquires an image and does the analysis. In this particular example, I am running in kind of a simulated mode. So normally the image that comes across would be the same size as the image acquired. So that concludes the setup of the CIB software to interface with the inspection that you set up using VBAI. In additional tutorials, I'm going to get into some of the advanced features.